must be something underneath. From your heart, 'cause when your head's right, you take your time. There's something about the love of things you like. Fire when the strobe hits.
Hello students, how you all are at your home? I hope that you all are fine and doing great at your home. So you all are welcome to Vidya Balbhavan Senior Secondary School in English World in class 9th, subject English by Ms. Purnima Bhardwaj. Let us have instructions first. You have to upload your homework on the portal. If you have doubts, mail them on pwrnimavbb@gmail.com or on vbbseniors@gmail.com. Okay, next is take a pencil with you to underline the difficult words and to write the meanings as well on this part. Write down all the words in with their meanings in Fair Notebook. Do all the uploaded work in Fair Notebook, uploaded work as in the word meanings and the question answers. Okay, so let's move on to the next slide. You just to identify these clips or pictures. This is clip number 1. Clip number 2. Clip number 3. Clip number 4. What does these clips make you observe? Okay, what have you observed from these clips? Okay, let me tell you, these are the clips of wind. Okay, wind as in the air pressure, wind comes at a high level, that is known as wind. Okay, these pictures are for wind. So we are on book 1 Beehive, poem number 2, that is wind. Okay, we will have this poem in today's video. Okay students, let us have the objectives of this video. First is introduction of the poet. Next is introduction of poem. Then word meanings with accent. Next is reading and explanation. Okay, I will give you the sentence stanza wise the explanation of this poem, and then we will have the recapitulation. And now let's have the introduction of the writer. Chinna Swami Subramania Bharati, also known as Bharatiyar, okay, born on 11 December 1882 and died on 11 September 1921, was a Tamil writer, poet, journalist, Indian independence activist, a social reformer, and a polyglot. Popularly known as Mahakavi Bharati, great poet Bharati, he was a pioneer of modern Tamil poetry and is considered one of the greatest Tamil literary figures of all time. His numerous works included Feeri's songs, kindling patriotism during the Indian independence movement. Bharati's influence on Tamil literature is phenomenal. Although it is said that he was proficient in around 14 languages, his favorite language is Tamil. He was prolific in his output. He covered political, social, and spiritual themes. The songs and poems composed by Bharati are often used in Tamil cinema and have become staples in the literary and musical repertoire of Tamil artists throughout the world. He paved the way for modern blank verse. He wrote many books and poems on how Tamil is beautiful in nature. And you can here see the picture of Chinna Swami Subramania Bharati. okay, he is the person who is a Tamil writer, poet, journalist, and Indian independence activist, a social reformer, and a polyglot. Okay, he's very famous. Okay, and he also wrote many kind of poetry. Okay, and now let's have the introduction of the poem. Okay, we all know that wind is a natural phenomena. In this poem, the poet talks to the wind. Okay, in this poem, this Subramania is talking to the wind. The poet, the power of wind has been described, and the poet says that wind is destructive. Obviously, when wind comes, it used to destroy many trees and many huts. Okay, many kind of things the wind used to destroy. He has linked the destructive power of wind to the adversities of the life and says that the weak people break down, but stronger people emerge out of adversities stronger. The poem gives an important message that we should be mentally tough and physically strong in order to survive and hardships of life. The weak person breaks down while like a weak building or crumbles. We must make these destructive forces our friends with our strength and determination. Okay, all he wants to say that our life is also like a wind. Okay, if wind comes, okay, the weak people and the weak things used to get destroyed, but the strong things will not gonna destruct if wind comes. Okay, so similarly, poet is saying that we have to be very strong, like the things, like the trees, that they do not get destroyed by the wind. Okay, we should be very strong. Any problem comes in our life, we should stand firmly and we have to just face the problems very finely. Okay, this was the motto, we can say, of this poem. Okay, let's have the word meanings of this poem, students. Poking fun means making fun of something. Next is weaklings. weaklings. Weaklings means a person who is weak. Poking fun. P-O-K-I-N-G. Poking, F-U-N, fun. Third one is crumbling. C-R-U-M-B-L-I-N-G. Crumbling means falling or to cause something to break. Next is rafter. R-A-F-T-E-R. Sloping beam which support the roof of the building. Next is winnows. W-I-N-N-O-W-S. Winnows means to break grain free of chaff or separate grain from husk by blowing on it. Next is steadfast. Steadfast. S-T-E-A-D-F-A-S-T. Fast. Firm means firm. Next is flourish. F-L-O-U-R-I-S-H. Flourish means grow. And now we will go towards the poem. Okay, now we'll move on towards our poem. So here is your poem, Wind. The wind blows strongly and causes a lot of destruction. How can we make friends with it? Okay, so what the poet is saying, I have given the introduction. Okay, now let's come to the poem. And I will tell you the stanza wise the meaning of this poem. Okay, but let me have the intonation and the modulation in this poem. Wind, come softly. Don't break the shutters of the windows. Don't scatter the papers. Don't throw down the books on the shelf. There, look what you did. You threw them all down. You tore the pages of the books. You brought rain again. You were very clever at poking fun at weaklings. Frail crumbling houses, crumbling doors, crumbling rafters, crumbling wood, crumbling bodies, crumbling lives, crumbling hearts. The wind god winnows and crushes them all. He won't do what you tell him. So, come, let's build strong homes. Let's join the doors firmly. Practice to firm the body. Make the heart steadfast. Do this and the wind will be friends with us. The wind blows out weak fires. He makes strong fires roar and flourish. His friendship is good. We praise him every day. So this is the poem, students, and now I will tell you the stanza wise meaning of this poem. Okay, so here is first stanza, and that is, wind comes softly. Don't break the shutters of the windows. Don't scatter the papers. Don't throw down the books on the shelf. Okay, these were the destruction, or we can say the destroyness of the wind, or destruction of the wind that used to make. Okay, the wind is coming softly, but when it comes regularly or continuously, what it do? It breaks the shutters of the windows, scatter the papers, throw down the books from the shelf. Okay, what he says next, there, look what you did, you threw them all down. What poet is saying to the wind, that look what you have done. Okay, you have threw them all down. You tore the pages of the book. You brought rain again. You are very clever at poking fun at weaklings. Okay, what he is saying, that he is blaming the wind for all the destructions and the destroy done by him. Okay, he brought the rain again, he tore the pages. Okay, he is very clever at poking fun at weaklings, to the poor people. Weaklings, who are here, means poor people or poor things that are weak things. Okay, and poking means making fun of something. Okay, he is making fun of the poor thing. Okay, the weak thing. Let's have the explanation part, students. Students, you don't have to worry. I will mail you, I will upload this on the portal. Okay, you will have this. The poet is talking to the wind. He asks the wind to come softly. So he's saying that the wind should not be very strong or loud. It should be soft and subtle. Then he says that the wind is very powerful. It is destructive. It breaks the shutters of windows and scatters the paper. When the wind is very powerful, all the books which are kept on the shelf fall down. So here the poet is describing the power of the wind. Then he says to the wind to look at the destruction that it had done. Whenever there is a strong wind, all the things that are weak, like small plants, tiny children, etc., they all get scared and they can even fall and get hurt. We can say that in the initial part of the poem, the poet is referring to wind as a young child. He is saying that it should come softly, just like a small child does. In the later part, we come to know that the wind is destructive, just like a youth, just like a young boy or a young girl who is full of energy, violence and destruction. Here is the explanation of whole the stanza, students. Okay, so here the poet is telling that, first of all, he is comparing the wind with the small child, okay, that comes very softly, and then he is just comparing with the destructive, just like a youth, okay, just like a young girl that is full of energy, violence and destruction. Now let's have the next part, next stanza. Frail crumbling houses, crumbling doors, crumbling rafters, crumbling wood, crumbling bodies, crumbling lives, crumbling hearts. Crumbling over here means falling or to cause something to break. Rafter means sloping beam which support the roof of the building. So what he is saying, that here the word crumbling is repeated so many times to lay stress that everything crumbles in the face of a strong wind. So the writer is saying that when wind is very powerful, it is very strong, it leads to breakage of everything. Houses which are weak fall, doors which are weak fall, the beams on which the roof of the buildings are supported, they are also fall. All the wooden structures fall, all bodies of people fall, animals, lives, hearts, everything just fall. And So he's saying that everything crumbles, means falls. Everything that is weak reacts by falling down and breaking in the face of adversity. So the poet is saying that whenever a weak person faces any adversity or challenge in life, he breaks down and falls. Okay, what he is saying now, he is comparing the things with the person. Okay, whenever the weak person is there or challenges are there and he used to fail in the challenges, the problem comes. Okay, he just fails and breaks down himself. He loses all the motivation he was just having. So wind is a kind of destructive element in the life of a person. Okay, let's get to the next stanza. The wind god winnows and crushes them all. Winnows means to break grain free of chaff. Separate grain from husk by blowing on it. Now the poet is addressing the wind to wind god. And he is saying that the powerful god of wind winnows. That means he sifts all the people, and those people who are weak fall down and get crushed. So here a comparison is made between wheat and people. Just like we winnow. Winnows means to break grain from chaff or to separate grain from husk by blowing on it. Just like we winnow. The wheat to separate the grain from chaff means the dirty things. The wind god separates the strong people from the weak. When there is a strong wind, all the things that are weak fall and get crushed. What he is saying that he is measuring, okay, he is just addressing the wind as wind god. Why? And he is just saying that wind, wheat and people, he has made a comparison in between. Why? Just like we know, the wheat to separate grain from chaff. Chaff is the dirty thing, okay, that is a weak thing, and the grain is a strong thing. Okay, like this only, the wind god separates the strong people from the weak. When there is a strong wind, all the things that are weak fall and get crushed, and the strong things never crushed. Okay, now let's go with the next stanza. He won't do what you tell him. So come, let's build strong homes. Let's joint the family, the doors firmly. Practice to firm the body, make the heart steadfast. Do this and the wind will be friends with us. What is he saying? Steadfast means firm. What is he saying? The poet wants to make friends with the winds, that is adversities in our life. He says that problems will not listen to us. They will come. So we should be prepared. Okay, we should get prepared for the problems. Okay, in preparations, we should build strong homes and close the doors of the house firmly so that the wind cannot get into. Okay, so students, what poet is saying that we just have to make ourselves strong. Okay, our willpower and everything, our bodies, our hearts, everything should be strong, and we have to accept the challenges. Do not go away from the challenges, because whenever we are going away from the problems follow us. Yes, it happens. And when we are strong and we are having good heart and we are firm with this, we can face that. Okay, for example, giving both in class 10th is very big challenge for you. Okay, but those who have given and reached to class 11th, they are just very confident that I have given the both and I am very confident to give the next one also. So whenever you are facing the problem, you are just being more confident. Okay. And then he says that we should also make our bodies strong and hearts firm to face these challenges. And then once we are strong enough, all the challenges will be like friends. We will not feel that they are troublesome, means they are troubling us. The wind blows out weak fires. He makes strong fires roar and flourish. His friendship is good. We praise him every day. The poet has kept the wind on a pedestal. Okay. Pedestal. He is comparing the wind to God. He says that wind is God and we praise wind every day. we are thanking him to make us strong, make us grow, make us become stronger and all. Okay, he adds that everything that is weak gets finished off in the face of the strong wind. Whatever our problems is there, okay, when we are impatient, we are not confident enough to face the problems, he is just erasing all our weakness, okay, all our the things which are negative or we mustn't have that. The wind is erasing all that. Okay, and what he says next is, all the things that are strong flourish and grow to become stronger. He is giving us a very important message that we should not feel bad and that we are facing so many challenges and adversities in life. We should make ourselves physically and mentally strong to face these challenges. And once we are strong enough, we will overcome the challenges, we will become friends with them, and then we will be happy that we had these challenges in our life because they help us become stronger and better. Everyone is having problem nowadays. We must take an example of India or world. We all are suffering from a disease, means a virus named as COVID-19. Okay, we all are aware of this virus, and many of the people have been died because they were not strong. Their immunity is not strong. Why China is not able to cope up with this virus? Because their immunity system is very weak. We can say that. But India's immunity system is very healthy, and we all are keeping care of ourselves so that we are not being attacked by this virus. Similarly, we must also take care of ourselves also. We must not panic when problem comes. We just have to confront this. Okay, with this we are end with the poem, students. Okay, students, just take your pens, your pencils and your blue pen, gel pen, black pen. Okay, and just note down the question and answers of this poem. Okay, start writing it. Question number one, what are the things that wind does in the first stanza? Write down the answer. In the first stanza, the wind breaks the shutters of the windows, scatters the papers, throws down the books from the shelf, tears the pages of the books and brings showers of rain. Next question, have you seen anybody winnow grain at home or in a paddy field? What is the word in your language for winnowing? What do people use for winnowing? Give the words in your language if you know them. Answer, yes, I have seen many women winnowing grain in villages. Pachuraniyas is the word used in my language for winnowing. People use chhazd or winnowing fan for winnowing purpose. Okay, now write down question number three. What does the poet say, the wind god winnows? The poet says that the wind god winnows the weak crumbling houses, doors, rafters, wood, bodies, lives and hearts, and then crushes them all. Now write down the question number four. What should we do to make friends with the wind? Answer, to make friends with the wind, we need to build strong homes with firm doors. Full stop. We should also make ourselves physically and mentally strong by building strong, firm bodies and having steadfast hearts. Let's have the next question. Write down question number five. What do the last four lines of the poem mean to you? Answer. In the last four lines, comma, the poet inspires us to face the wind, which symbolizes the hardships of our lives, courageously. Full stop. He tells us that the wind can only extinguish the weak fires. It intensifies. INTENSIFIES intensifies the stronger ones. Similarly, adversitize, deter the weak hearted, but strengthens those who have unflattering will. In such a case, befriending the wind, or the hardships of life makes it easier for us to face them. Full stop. And rest of the two questions are homework for you students. You have to do that on your own, okay? And now we will just have the recapitulation. Okay, let's have the recapitulation of the video. We have done the introduction of the poet, introduction of the poem, word meanings with accent, reading and explanation, and we have done the question answers as well. Okay, and we are doing the recapitulation. Okay, so in the end, I would like to say thank you everyone. Take care of yourself. Do all the work in your notebook fair, and your exams are going to be start in the August 2nd week. Be prepared for that for July syllabus. Thank you.